Welcome back. My name is Eva Benes with Pain-Free for Life Pilates, and in today's video, I would like to show you some stretches that make your body feel great after skiing. So most of the complaints after skiing are related to tightness in the feet, in the lower legs, soreness in the knees, in the hips, the quadriceps, and also the lower back and the shoulders. I would like to take you through a short stretching routine that's gonna make you feel much better. So first things first, let's address the lower legs and the feet. Since your feet are in the ski boots or snowboarding boots all day long, they get really sore. First, just cross your foot over your knee and using your knuckles, give your lower leg a gentle massage. That muscle on the front of the lower leg that gets really sore is called your anterior tibialis. Also, the side of the lower leg where your peroneal muscles run, just massage them with your knuckles and give them a little relief. After that, hold on to the top of your foot, stabilize your lower leg with your other hand, and just pull your foot away from the shin, from the lower leg, and just allow those muscles to stretch out. Also hold on, grab your foot, and circle your foot around as you're keeping your lower leg stable. Reverse the circle. Also, if your toes were squished together in your boots, it's gonna feel really good if you just run your fingers in between your toes and create some space in between them, stretch them out. So you wanna massage the front of the shin, the side of the lower leg, and then you wanna pull the top of your foot away from your shin and circle it around. Repeat that on the second side as well. Massage the anterior tibialis, massage the peroneals, cross over, hold on to the top of your foot, pull your foot away from your lower leg so you feel a nice stretch on the front of the shin. And then just thread your fingers in between the toes and circle your foot around about 5 times and then reverse the direction. And then get down on the floor and get into sort of like a child pose position that will further stretch your shins and the top of your feet. Put your hands in front of you, then walk your hands as far to the right side as you can. That will give you a nice opening on the left side of your back. Try and take some nice deep inhales, breathe into the stretching side of your back. Feel that your ribcage expands and it will give you a deeper stretch. Now let's repeat that on the second side. Walk your hands as far towards the left as you can. You should feel a nice intense opening in the right side of your back. Similar to the other side, take a nice deep inhale, breathe into the lower part of your lungs, and that should give you a nice deep stretch in the side of your body. Next, we're gonna stretch the hip flexors. You use them a lot during skiing, so they will appreciate a nice stretch. Just drop your hip forward, squeeze your butt, engage your core, lengthen up, and just open up the front of the hip. Hold the stretch for about 30 seconds. And then let's repeat that on the second side. So left hip goes forward, abdominals are engaged. Be sure not to overarch your lower back and hold your stretch for about 30 seconds. Then we're gonna take a seat and just cross your right foot over your left knee in order to open up the piriformis. You can just do this seated or lay down on your back, hold on to the back of your left leg so you feel a nice deep stretch on the right, in the back of the right hip. And just like with the hip flexor stretch, hold it for about 30 seconds. And then change your legs, hold on to the back of the right leg. Use your left elbow or left hand to push that left knee a little bit away. And you'll feel a little bit deeper of a stretch. And then after 30 seconds, just simply roll over onto your side and we'll do a nice quadricep stretch, front of the thigh stretch. So just grab your foot, try and align your knee with your hip, be sure it's not ahead of your body. And engage your glutes, that will give you a deeper stretch in the quadriceps. And then we'll repeat this on the second side. Hold the foot, engage your core. It's important not to overarch the lumbar spine. And just enjoy that nice après-ski stretch in the front of the thigh, front of the hip. You can let it go. And oftentimes, people feel sore in their shoulders and in their upper body too after skiing. So let's finish with a really nice shoulder and spine stretch. You're gonna extend your top arm out. The legs are stacked on top of each other. Then draw as big of a circle with your arm as you can. Roll onto your back as you do your circle. Open the chest towards the ceiling. Try and bring your upper back onto the floor behind you. Do about 5 repetitions. And then let's repeat on the second side. Legs are stacked, keep the lower body stable as you do your arm circle. And that will give you a deeper stretch in your shoulder, in your chest, in your back. And let's do one more repetition. And we are done. So this is a short, compact stretching routine. You can do that in about 5, 6, 7 minutes and your body is going to feel a whole lot better.